Did you ever wonder how a float switch worked? A float switch, like on a sump pump. Usually it's a can like this. It's attached to a wire. It goes up and down with the water. When it comes down, the switch turns off. When it goes up, when it gets to a certain point, the switch comes on, turns on the pump. There's a steel ball. The steel ball actuates this lever. This lever contains the jump across contacts. You have a drum. Inside the drum, there's a little bump inside here. It's kind of like a speed bump on a road. And that ball goes in there. It has to get to a certain level before the ball will jump out, go to the other side. Come back the other way. It has to get to a certain angle before it will jump over that speed bump. The ball jumping suddenly from one side to the other makes this a snap switch and prevents arcing the contact points. Most toggle switches work in a similar manner. It's a teeter-totter, flip-flop, rocks back and forth on this point. When the ball gets in one direction, comes across, these contacts close. When it gets to the other position, it opens, stops the pump. As the water rises, it increases in angle until the ball comes across and the contacts close. The pump's running till it opens. As the water fills up into the sump, it rises to a point, ball comes into here, starts the pump again. Very simple mechanism. Until the can started leaking around the seal on the wire and filled partially full of water. Then the float wasn't floating anymore. So. Sometimes you'll find in the older ones, there'll be a mercury switch. To get away from the mercury, they've come up with this mechanism. Very dependable as long as it stays dry inside. The reason this leaked, made in China.